Okay, all right, here we go. So we're gonna start matrices. Okay? If I was you guys, I would get a couple of color pencils, okay? So you're gonna want something to possibly help you color code this. All right, it's not hard, but there is a lot of detail. And you're gonna want some color pencils to kind of help you decipher what's going on, okay? So matrices are another way that we can solve systems of equations. Okay. A matrix is going to look like this. It's going to be like a box with brackets. Okay. All of the numbers and stuff inside of it, we're going to refer to as elements. All of these will have dimensions. Okay. M and M. M is going to stand for, what's it say?
Rows.
Rows, okay? And everybody knows that rows go left to right, right? Rows go left to right. And columns go up and down, okay? So like this one has two rows, two columns. This one has two rows, but it has one, two, three, four, five columns. Okay, this is going to be important when we start adding, subtracting, and multiplying. This one has one, two, three rows and one column. Okay, so far so good? All right, so let's look at this first one. All right. Okay, so special names, we're not going to get into a bunch of worrying about how to name these, okay? The main thing is, we're going to need to just know how to fill in these spots, or we're going to need to know how to use these to add and subtract them. So don't get all caught up in this, okay? You need to know how to name it as far as M, N, okay? How many rows and columns. I'm not worried about you naming the individual elements. All right. So if they have the exact same dimensions, we say that they are equal. So if I have a 2x2, and a 2x2, they are equal, okay? All right, so let's look at these. It wants us to find the values for X and Y that make this true, okay? So let's talk about what this means. This is a fancy way of saying that Y equals what? Yes. Okay, and it's just a fancy way of saying, what about X?
X equals 2Y.
Okay. Now, what they want us to do is they want us to find the values that would make this true. You could either use elimination or you could use substitution. What would be your easiest one here?
Substitution.
Absolutely. Okay, which one would you substitute into the other one? Yeah, I would take this one and plug it in for X. Okay, so Y would equal 2 times 2Y minus 6. Then what? Good. 4Y minus 6, 3Y equals negative 6. Sorry, I'm jumping ahead. Y equals negative 2. If that's what Y equals, how do I find out what X is? Plug in. So this is what we've been doing. Okay?
Where'd you get a negative
2? Whenever we subtracted this over, it should have been positive. Thank you. It was a negative divided by a negative.
Wait, so did you add the 6 over?
I subtracted the 4y over. Here. Sorry.
How'd you get 6?
Okay. It was in our equation. So I substituted this in here for x. And our equation was 2x minus 6, right? Y equals 2x minus 6. We put this in for x. Okay, so I got 4y minus 6. We just bring the 6 down.
X equals 6.
Oh, okay, so when we put in y for 2, oh, I'm sorry, 4. Good grief, my brain's not awake this morning, I'm sorry. Okay, thank you for catching that, sorry. Should be 4. How can we find out if this was right? Which obviously I need to check my work. So we plug it in where? Okay, so we plug them in either one, does it matter? Which one's the easiest one to plug back into? Both of them. Okay, so does 4 equal, we plug that in, 4? Yes, it does. Yeah. Okay. Any questions on those?
No.
All right, let's go to the next one. Okay, we're not going to do a bunch like that. This is mainly what we're going to start doing. Okay, so we're going to add them.
This is not how you like
this. Say it again.
Do.
Do you not like matrices?
No.
They're easy. They are.
There's too many.
Okay. Now, the only way, so let me go back to this one really quick. The only way that I can add or subtract matrices are they have to be what? They have to be.
They have to have the same number of columns.
Good. Okay, so they have to match up equal. They have to be equal. I have to have the same number of rows and same number of columns, okay? And here's why. When we go to add these, we're going to add spot for spot. So what I mean by that is, what is in the same spot as negative 2 over there?
Negative 6.
Negative 6. Okay, so whenever I add those together, because this is negative 2 plus a negative 6, what do I get? And it goes in that same exact spot. Okay, I added these in the top, okay, top left. So then I'm gonna move over. Zero, what's in the same spot as zero?
7.
Which would be?
7.
Okay, I guess I should color code these. Okay, I'm probably not gonna have enough colors to do all of these, but you'll get the idea. So what's in the same spot as 1?
-1.
Okay, and 1 plus -1 is?
0.
0. Good. Okay, what is in the same spot as my 0?
4.
Okay, and 4 plus 0 is?
4.
Okay, what about my 5?
5 minus 3 is 2.
Okay, and? Okay, negative 8 plus positive 10 is a positive 2. All right, so we started with the name this. What is this? Is this a 2 by 3 or is it a 3 by 2?
2 by 3.
2 by 3, rows then columns. This is a 2 by 3 plus a
2 by 3.
Okay, and what was my end result?
That. 2 by 3.
A 2 by 3. So anytime I'm adding and subtracting, okay, these are going to be the same all the way through. If you do something and get all the way down here to the end and you don't have the same thing that you started with, the same dimension, something happened. Okay, something happened.
Is that all we do?
That's all we do for addition.
Are we just doing addition and subtraction today?
We're not going to do all 4.
Can we just do addition and subtraction?
Okay. All right, let's do subtraction. Look, I color-coded those. How funny. Okay, same thing with subtraction. I'm going to show you 2 methods here. Okay? All right. So, first off, do we have the same dimensions? Okay, then I can go ahead and do this. Now, there's 2 ways you can do this. You can think of this as adding and negating everything over here.
Can we just subtract it?
Or you can subtract it, which is going to be subtracting a negative at times. You decide which one you like, okay? So I can add these and reverse all my signs, or if I leave it this way, I have 9 minus an 8. Or I have 4 minus a negative 2. So if that is going to confuse you, minus a negative, I would suggest flipping this to positive and negating everything over here. So you tell me what you want to do. Do you want to leave it as minus or do you want to negate everything?
Add.
Okay, she said add. So we're going to add and negate. All right, so here we go. What is in the same spot as my 9?
8. Negative 8.
Okay, good. So 9 minus 8 is?
1.
It goes in that same spot. What's in the same spot as 4?
2.
Okay. And if you didn't negate it, it would be 4 minus a negative 2, which makes that a positive. So this would be?
Four, six.
Okay. What's in this same
five.
Spot? So this would be a 5.
2.
Okay. So 3 minus 1 is a positive 2. So the same spot as my 0.
5.
Started with, what are the dimensions of this one?
3 by 3.
Mm-hmm. There's how many rows? 1, 2, 3. And how many columns?
2.
Okay, what about this one?
Yes.
What did we end up with?
3 by 2.
Okay. I really think we could go ahead and do a multiplication.
Yeah, can we please?
Please,
my brain is.
Yeah.
We also have the other thing to do on the homework, too. And there's like 9
six
following that.
Okay. All right. So we'll go ahead and stop there with the addition and subtraction. Was there any other examples before we move on?
No.
Okay. So you're going to do the addition and subtraction ones on that page.